Okay, so what you've just been watching is, of course, a time-lapse sequence that shows the honeybees and wasps eating dry, regular sugar. But the interesting thing is that what happens while they're trying to eat sugar, first of all, it's only 39 or 40 degrees at the beginning of that sequence, and that's what we're watching right here. That's also why we have the conspicuous absence of the honeybee. The wasps can get out and fly early. They fly in the cold. And even though this sugar here on this feeder is spread out, they all pile in a tight cluster and they chew away at the granules of sugar together. And that's interesting to me because I expected, well, they would just spread out and maybe gather it. I am interested in seeing how they metabolize dry sugar. But they chew it. And they chew it together, they push their faces together, and they grab at one another's mouths, which is very interesting also. So the honeybees fly out later when it starts to warm up. Generally, the honeybees are airborne at 50 degrees. If the sun's really out on the landing boards and they heat up, they'll fly out a little sooner, but often they can't handle it. So here we have yellow jackets and some other paper wasp species. And they're all chewing away at granulated sugar. Now, if you keep watching, you're going to see a behavior that's very interesting. Because nearby, there are bees that have been on these feeders overnight. And they just sit tight and wait to warm up in place. Now, that puts a honeybee in jeopardy when they're out clinging to plants or when they're sitting, in this case, on bricks that I use to weight down these drinkers. The wasps can get around and completely take advantage of honeybees that are, for all practical purposes, defenseless until they warm up and they get airborne. So keep watching and I'll show you what I'm talking about. I'm sure somebody watching is going to be familiar with the different species of wasps that we're looking at here, and I'm just guessing that the one at the 7 o'clock position there is a queen. She's much larger than any of the others, but if you know the difference, please chime in and let us know. I'd appreciate it. Now, as you watch that first 2-minute sequence, you saw that this group of yellow jackets did sweep completely across, but their numbers increased, and you'll also notice in the time-lapse sequence that the regular honeybees showed up, and that really changed things and sped up the consumption of the granulated sugar. Notice also that even though there are different species of wasps here, they are not fighting one another. They are just trying to get the same food. Now here's an example of a honeybee that I was explaining about earlier. Look at the one on the left side there that's head down. They'll often cling to a plant or they'll sit on bricks, as they are in this case, and they're unable to move because it hasn't warmed up enough. Remember, it's 39 or 40 degrees. The sun is not warming the surface that they're sitting on. So the wasps that are in the vicinity can do anything they want to a honeybee. And if you look at these bees right here, I initially thought when I watched this wasp approach that, oh, well, he'll just attack this honeybee and possibly even dispatch it and take the food back so they can feed grubs. But that's not what's going on at all. And with these bumblebees here, again, they're getting a slow start. They've been here overnight and they can't fly yet either. Now we're back to that honeybee. Look what's going on. If you weren't paying close attention, it would look like this wasp is chewing at the bee, but it's not. This honeybee was at the drinkers, which are sugar water, and it has residual sugar syrup dried on its body. And this wasp came along and licked the sugar off of the bee, including the wings, the eyes, the antenna, and everything else. And I know that's a nightmare for this honeybee that's not warmed up and able to defend itself, but it just had to sit there and allow the wasp to work it over and clean off all of that sweet residue. Here's another one getting the same treatment. Notice too the size of the wasp. It's every bit as large as this female worker honeybee. And it is just licking away on every part of the bee. And didn't do anything to injure the bee. This was a remarkable behavior because from a distance you would assume that the wasps are attacking and harming honeybees, but they really aren't. It's just working its way around and collecting residue of sugar syrup. And this poor bee sits here and just has to take it because it cannot. It's kind of like sleep paralysis. It's sitting there and the wasp comes up and does whatever it wants. So that honeybee is really at the mercy of the wasp, and the wasp is capable of flying and moving around in much colder temperatures than the bee. So this was a surprise. Now if you watch also, watch the wasp's antenna as it touches and pats on the honeybee. Lots of unexpected behavior here. And notice too that the sun is picking up a little, and that will begin to warm the bee so it can start to move around. And it definitely would not put up with this wasp if it were warmed and ready to fly. Of course, I'm not going to just leave this bee sitting here. You'll find that if you bring some 50-50 sugar water along, and as these dormant bees are waking up in the morning, if you feed them sugar water, that carbohydrate will kick them right into gear. This is the sugar water that I've put down for them, and the honeybees just all wake up and start drinking right away. And look who's right in the middle of the mix here. The yellow jacket is right in with the honeybees, and so long as there are resources present, they are not attacking one another. They're simply sharing sugar water. And notice how frenzied their behavior becomes once that resource is gone and they're just combing over the surface of this prey. So we add a little more for them. You can see little driblets of sugar water even on the bodies of the bees here and on that wasp who's had his face in the camera. Now, why is it that wasps are able to fly in cold temperatures while the honeybees have to wait to warm up? And the way honeybees warm up is they vibrate their flight muscles, much like humans do when they shiver, and that burns calories and generates heat through their thorax so that they can fly. But wasps, for some reason, can fly no matter what the weather's doing and even in the rain. I hope you found this observation interesting. I'm glad that you watched my video, and I hope you'll watch future videos as well. Thank you so much.